We're back. You're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Outgoing White House aide Omarosa Manigault Newman is fighting back today against reports that she was fired from the White House following a dramatic confrontation with the chief of staff, General John Kelly. This is what she told ABC's Good Morning America.
I resigned, and I didn't do that in the residence as being reported. John Kelly and I sat down in the Situation Room, which is a very secure, very quiet room in the White House. And we had a very candid conversation. And I wanted to make the one-year mark. That was one of the goals that I set out to. And then get back to my life.
A source tells CNN that Omarosa did not resign, as you just heard her say, and that once she made it known she was going to appeal her case to the president himself, she was escorted out. Omarosa, of course, developed her professional relationship with Donald Trump while she was a contestant on his reality show, The Apprentice, and her loyalty has been unwavering to him ever since.
I ain't going nowhere, son!
I'm here because Mr. Trump invited me.
Whatever, today.
And if you keep saying that to him, you're going to be questioning his judgment, and I actually trust his judgment.
Omarosa, go out and sell paintings or whatever the hell you're doing. Omarosa has to go. You're fired.
Omarosa, you not only lost, you got creamed. You know, I've always been a big Omarosa fan, but Omarosa, you're fired.
Every critic, every detractor will have to bow down to President Trump. It is the ultimate revenge to become the most powerful man in the universe.
I've known him for more than a decade, and I've had an opportunity to not only work with him, to be on shows with him, but to visit his different properties and his business ventures. And women on those properties are paid higher than the men's in most cases. They perform well because there's an environment that's conducive for them to grow.
I now work for this country,
yes.
And I take my job very seriously.
With me now, two people who appeared on The Apprentice and Celebrity Apprentice with Omarosa, Kwame Jackson and Claudia Jordan. Kwame was runner-up on the very first season of The Apprentice, and also with us, Jonathan Wackrow, CNN law enforcement analyst and former Secret Service agent. So we can talk about how she was escorted off or not. Claudia, just to you first, can you tell me a little bit about your interactions with Omarosa? What was she like to you?
Well, we were friends. I never watched her when she did the show, and I got to know a lot more about her personality when we actually did Celebrity Apprentice All Stars together. And she just, to me, is someone that will say or do anything for self-preservation. And I mean, there's not many things that she sticks to besides what benefits herself. I mean, first she's proud to be the villain. Then she's a minister. She's a Democrat. Then she's a Republican. She's your friend, then she's not your friend.
What's that about? What's that about, you think?
I think when you lack integrity, you kind of go with the wind and you go with what's going to help you serve yourself. And I used to be her friend, so I just saw her change. I haven't seen her be, she's been loyal to Trump, but then today she talks about, I have a story to tell. And if you're so happy about your departure and you can't just go back to your regular life, but then you're making threats, basically, that you are going to snitch, basically. So what is it? Are you happy leaving? Are you not happy? I tend to believe the story about her being dragged out, kicking and screaming, because that was her life goal, to work in the White House with Donald Trump. And she got that job. There's no way she voluntarily left after 1 year. 1 year? Absolutely not.
Kwame, what are you thinking?
You know, this situation right now is not about Omarosa. Omarosa is the bright, shiny object. She is the strobe light that distracts us all. I think this situation right now about, you know, where we are is about focusing on, you know, the 97% of black women who turned out to vote against Roy Moore in Alabama. It's about the people who are trying to make change in our communities and actually who are advocating on behalf of the black community. I know that I spoke out very early and very often, you know, almost two and a half years ago in regards to Donald Trump running, and not many people kind of came to that leadership position. Obviously, Omarosa is on a different tangent. You know, I don't have anything personally against her, but, you know, the fact that he nominated her or appointed her as, you know, head of black community engagement, you know, that's like appointing, you know, Benedict Arnold as the head of the, you know, Revolutionary Army. And so I think there's an African-American community feeling that, you know, she has been disavowed, that there is no love lost for her. But we're really focused on moving forward as a community and, you know, the immediate issues in front of us.
Yeah, there was a moment yesterday, Angela or I, there was a bit of a bye girl bye.
Yeah, it was. I saw that.
From Miss Angela.
Lots of love to Angela.
There you go. even in the White House daily briefing, where you know one of the reporters was asking Sarah Sanders, okay, well, can you name one individual of color, you know, on the senior staff, and they couldn't.
I never saw any individual of color in his organization when I was on The Apprentice. You know, obviously on the senior staff, you don't see that in the White House. And to pull Omarosa in as your kind of, you know, minority whisperer or, you know, black person whisperer, I think that was the wrong choice.
As far as what exactly happened,
yes,
and we may never fully know, there are multiple versions of the story. Let me read for you what the Secret Service tweeted, because there was word that perhaps she was escorted off the property, that maybe she was trying to get into the residence. We were talking to April Ryan, who had all this great reporting. The Secret Service tweeted that they were not involved in escorting her out, but if there was indeed a dramatic confrontation, as our sources say, walk me through what would have happened or how this would have been handled.
Well, this is an organization, so this comes down to access control. After she was terminated, and I just kind of find there's a little sweet irony in this termination that it happened in the Situation Room, which is a boardroom, and she was terminated there. So I kind of see it as a little ironic. You're asked to leave. Yes, escorted out, but it doesn't mean escorted out by the Secret Service. Just if you're terminated from CNN, they will take your stuff and you will leave. You will hand over your pass and move on. Mm-hmm. There was no physical removal of her across the North Lawn and dragging her off the complex. First of all,
does that mean that someone else might have done that, or not necessarily?
No, that's if someone else does it, it's assault. So let me just be perfectly clear.
Thank you.
From the Secret Service standpoint, they are not putting hands on somebody to remove them from any facility unless there was, actually a violation of law. I mean, they're not going to, they're law enforcement officers. New York police officer doesn't just walk around the streets and grab people and drag them down the street, nor does a United States Secret Service, agent or officer of the White House. That didn't happen. I spoke to the Secret Service this morning.
Yeah.
They were very candid in their information that they gave me. I believe them 100%. And I don't know one agent or officer, quite frankly, that would put their job on the line to physically remove somebody without actually pressing charges against them.
Okay. Jonathan, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very
much.
Safe
travels to you, my friend. And Claudia, thank you so much. Appreciate
thank
all of you. Let's roll on. All of you. Let's roll on.